we all have our little rituals and things before we get going. And my day generally starts out where I'll go into my office and I'll look through my email, and then I have things that I do. I check the astronomy picture a day page and cute overload and the earthquake, world earthquake map to find out where the earthquakes are happening. And then sometimes I check ICANN has cheeseburger, and then I check the webcam on the volcano Popocatépetl in Mexico. And then I check my two news sources, BBC Online and MSNBC Online, for my news. Lately, in the last 10 months, I've been doing a lot of political blogging. I don't think it's going to go away entirely. But by the time I've done all of that, it's usually getting around 3 o'clock. And also there are errands. I've been in physical therapy for my shoulder and my knee lately, which is lots of fun. Around about 3 or 4 o'clock, I'm ready to start work. And the way I do it is not by hours. The way I work is by page limit. I have to make my page limit every day or I can't watch television. I have to make my page count before I can watch TV. And I like television. So when I'm starting out on a book, it takes that my start speed is usually about 5 pages a day, because I'm setting up characters, I'm setting up the plot, I'm setting up the themes. And then as I get going, I'm up to 6 or 7 pages. And this is the speed I'm at now, after more than 30 years of writing as a published adult. In the beginning, I was happy if I could do 1 or 2 pages a day. But I've been at this a long time, and usually I've been thinking about a book for a long time before I sit down to write it. So that's why I can do so much at any one date. In the middle, I'm going to 6 or 7 pages a day. And by the time I hit what the people in the radio company I helped to start in the 80s used to call the Pierce juggernaut, which is I get everything all lined up in a row, and all the little climaxes have happened, and now there's this huge juggernaut of plot teetering on the edge, and all I have to do is stand aside and let it drop, and it goes barreling down on the characters, and there's the earthquake and the forest fire and the war, and the ground opens up and the palace collapses inside, and the rats reign supreme over all. Then I'm doing 14 to 20 pages a day, and I'm just sitting there typing madly, cackling like a fiend and saying, good stuff, good stuff. And I still manage to get it all done before my favorite TV shows come on. And what I then do is also every day, my friend Bruce Koval, who is the author of Dark Whispers, The Song of the Unicorn, My Teacher's an Alien, Jeremy Thatcher, Dragon Hatcher. Bruce and I read together. So he'll bring over what manuscript he's working on, and then I'll read about 5 or 6 pages of what I'm doing, and he'll give me notes, and he'll read 5 or 6 pages of what he's doing, and I'll give him notes. So we do that every day as well, and that's part of our process when we're both in town.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Anne B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.